Hello and welcome to the show. I am back on a Car Mechanic Simulator today, taking a look at the latest DLC. This is the sort of extreme modifications DLC. Essentially, it gives us all sorts of crazy vehicles, and I have got, well, I'm going to build up one of them today. I've got two in my garage though. We have got the Mullark drag car that has V6 engine in the back of it. Admittedly, that is the DeLorean engine, which is pretty pants. However, considerably more power than the normal Mallark gets. Is the fuel tank normally the... I can't remember. It's been a long time since I've messed around with one of those. Either way, yeah, we've got an interesting sort. There's a few different sorts of cars. There's a few cars that get sort of W12 engines, a few get the V8 sort of in drag spec and so on. However, the vehicle that we're going to be building up does initially look rather dull. This is the Rhino Piccolo or something along those lines. It is a fairly basic, fairly kind of standard car that you get from the game. However, this has got by far the most extreme conversion of all of them, which is why we're going to play around with it. I'm also in the new sandbox mode, as you might have noticed, not in my normal black and orange garage. We've also got maxed out money, maxed out experience, and so on. So you can just mess around and play about with stuff, which is quite a cool feature. You can still, of course, play through the game normally if you want, but it's quite nice to have this as an option if you just want to mess around, much like I'm doing with this video, if you just want to mess around with some of the new parts and new cars, etc. So, I have stripped this car down. Again, you have to get these. As far as I can tell, in the sandbox mode, you should have to go and get them from the auction house. So I've stripped this one here down. It was like a one-star condition. It was awful. I've stripped it down and I've bought all new bits and pieces for it. Hopefully, I've bought everything that we need to go with this car. I'm sure I won't have done. And we are going to make this as powerful as possible. As you can see, we have a V8. Yes, this is a V8 five-seat hatchback thing that we are going for here. I've gone through and got all the optional parts. I kind of didn't know what bits I needed and sort of bought everything. So there's all sorts of bits lying around. I'll probably have far more parts than I actually need because I just kind of spam clicked since I can, as we have got unlimited money. Oh, come on, there we go. We can click on these bits and pieces eventually. There we go. Importantly, we have got clips. That is all sorted. We have got an upgraded power steering pump, which is always nice. We're going to have to lift this up in a minute. Yep. We have to have the car down to put the engine block in. They want to lift it up to do most of the other bits and pieces. I'd say it's a bit of a faff. There's just lots of going up and downs with the lift. We'll do the engine in here first. Yeah, V8 in this littler car is quite a drastic change, I think is the word to go for. It's quite an impressive can we spin camera, there we go, quite an impressive change. The sandbox mode I have got in kind of normal difficulty. It's kind of weird. I've got used between playing this and playing my summer car, or playing this in the expert mode that I have been doing previous, and playing my summer car, I've got used to just sort of guessworking and trying to find places to click and so on. So it's actually quite nice to now have, look at all of these like specifically made areas and outlines to work with. Does make things a little bit easier. It does kind of flow a little bit easier as well when it comes to building. I don't know how much power this is going to get when I'm done with it, because I can't remember how much crazy power the V8 does when it's completely modified out. As you can see here, each of these parts are adding sort of a small percentage increase. I think the V8 on its own comes out at about 400-ish horsepower. And these cylinder heads add 10% power on each. And, you know, the pistons were adding a little bit. It all adds up to hopefully quite a lot. Okay, I haven't got an intake manifold. That's something that we do need to get. We'll get some camshafts on, though. I did have a look, and I don't think it'll work if we go right there. There are options, should be in theory options down here. Okay, so intake manifold V8 or supercharger intake manifold, and I don't think I can go and stick the supercharger one on. We are going to buy it just in case. I should probably check in here. Is there a performance intake? Performance intake manifold V6. There isn't a performance intake manifold for the V8. That's a little bit of a shame. I think they've added more performance parts for W12 engines as well. just as an information. No, we can't put the supercharger right, so we can't kind of cheat and change the aspiration without sort of saying, or without going through the basic options, and there isn't, I say basic options, I should explain. If we press F1, it'll say swap engine. Now, if there are engines to swap to, then they would be in here. Because this is going in a slightly weird car, I don't think it lets us play around with different V8s. So we can't have a supercharger in this, which is a little bit of a shame. Now, if you don't know what this DLC is about, then that little engine swap screen will give you the first clue as to what craziness this car might have in store for us all. It's going to be spectacular. It's going to be spectacular indeed. I accidentally started buying the wrong spark plugs. That's why I have some of them hanging around. And over this side as well. Put in one of the wrong spark plugs. That's just kind of instinct. Grab the first one you see. And then we want to go disassemble mode. Get rid of that. Gosh, really weird having all colours and so on, is it? Right. Engine is starting. So we need two timing chains, don't we? Not timing chains. We're going to find them in here. Timing chain V8 somewhere. Am I blind? It's not chain. Don't mind me. I'm being very stupid as per usual. Timing belt V8. I believe we need two of them. Yeah, there doesn't seem to be a specific one or two, so... Yep, that'll go on there. Then we can get a nice cover on here. I didn't buy any bodywork parts. I don't know if there are different options for these custom cars. I'm sure we will find out relatively quickly. I think I didn't buy cylinder head covers either. We can get them. I've kind of been prepared-ish on this one. I've got a million different idle... I didn't bother counting how many and just kind of spam-clicked my way through and bought a whole bunch of them, so we should have enough. Is there a water pump in the performance shop? There are some different pumps. Fuel pump, power, steering. There isn't a water one, so we will have just the sort of standard V8 one going on here. That can go there. Things are going much smoother than they tend to go on my summer car. The vehicle hasn't glitched through the floor. It hasn't had a wobbly moment at all in all of this. I do kind of wish with my summer car that you could get slightly crazier vehicles. They may well come. They may well come in time. And I like that this game is now going kind of full crazy with its vehicles, with its options. To me, that's always a good thing. To me, it's always a good thing when you give us the option to do crazier and crazier stuff with cars. Like, putting a V8 in this, it shouldn't really happen, but I like that it allows us to do it, and the same with the V6. In that, it's a very, very cool DLC, and one that I wasn't expecting. I'll be honest, I was not expecting to see a sort of crazy car. Oopsie, that's not what we wanted at all. There we go, I can spell. We wanted engine head cover black V8, I think, is the one. Maybe it was that one. You know what? We've got more than enough money not to care. Oopsie, I bought way too many of some of those. I didn't mean to double-click on it. Sure, we'll see what ones it lets us use. It is the black head covers. Okay, sure. I can't remember what the difference... I think the red ones go on the slightly higher power version of the engine. I'm not 100% sure. There's a little bolt over that one. There we go, and then we have got some fancy ignition coils. It doesn't tell us the percentage increase in performance in this menu that I thought it did, which is that's a little bit of a shame. It's kind of guesswork. It just means I'm not going to be able to inform you at this precise moment in time. I would be expecting to potentially get 800-900 horsepower out of this engine. Oh, for God's sake. At some point, my kind of automatic applying of parts mode will work. No, I've done exactly... Oh, God's sake. This isn't the normal problem that you have when putting cars together. You don't normally mean to click on one part and then accidentally install the wrong one twice in a row. It's not something... Oh, I have bought that. I'm surprised. I thought I would have forgotten those bits. Right. That's all there. We can get... I bought two throttles. There we go. We're fine. We'll have double throttles on this one. Sure. I think we've got... fuel filter. I'm pretty sure there'll be more and more performance parts added as time has gone on with this game, which means that you can get even more and more power out of these cars. Look at that shiny exhaust. It'll be shiny until oil starts leaking out of everywhere, which, knowing my construction of cars, certainly knowing my history on my summer car, oil will leak no matter whether I can find what's going on or not. There shall be oil leaking everywhere, or my history with Car Mechanic Simulator is forgetting to put oil in the first place. So it's going to be one or the other. Either is not particularly good for your vehicle. Is that our engine mostly complete? I think it is. We'll put in the radiator while we are here, and the fan. I think everything else has to be done from underneath the car. Battery can go in. Yeah, because we've got to get to the oil pan. We've got to get underneath the vehicle. Right. Up we go on the lift. And then we can start work on the on the suspension and so on. At the moment, things still look relatively tame. Things look relatively tame on our vehicle. If we go and stick in the nice front crossmember, you can kind of see, maybe you can kind of guess where we're going with this one, because there is a fair amount of ride height going on. Oh, did I not buy any... I don't think I bought any tie rods. I don't think I bought any outer ones either. Tie rods. Let's get some of them. I'm surprised I managed to forget them of all things, but there we go. Shall we work on this corner first? I think we shall, yes. Yeah, this is a slight monster truck. They call it the Monster Piccolo, which I'm not quite sure on, because while it is sort of a raised one, it's sort of using... normal-ish suspension, like this suspension configuration, but this is all using parts that we've seen in other cars. This is all, you know, all of these bits that we've got going on now are the same that we have seen in, perhaps even in the standard car, to be honest. It's just kind of slightly higher. I'm thinking maybe the front crossmember bit is a little bit different in this one, and that's where it gets its... Well, I say it's a little bit different. It's also a lot lower, kind of in comparison to where the engine is perhaps the easiest way of explaining it. Much like with, well, general Car Mechanic Simulator stuff, the level of detail is very, very good on here, but it's not quite sort of my summer car levels. And you don't have to worry about kind of where this stuff connects. Bits will sort of float slightly. So, yeah, we can kind of see where the cross member kind of comes down underneath the car. I think the normal cross member would sort of sit level with the sort of the black part of the under tray, essentially. But there's no sort of fancy ways of connecting it up. It just kind of sits down there, as you know it does kind of when you have built up a normal car on here. There's not all of the real fine details, which I was perhaps slightly hoping for when we have these crazy contraptions. However, it still works. You still can mess around with the cards. I don't know, because I haven't checked whether you get these... I don't know, I assume you would get these custom cars come into the shop when you're doing jobs. In this sandbox mode that I'm playing in, there is no phone calls. There are no jobs to do, because this is just about kind of buying and customizing and messing around with the new cars. However, in all the previous DLCs, they've always had the cars show up, like Maseratis and the Bentleys and so on, would show up in the job sort of phone calls, the phone jobs. So I would imagine that these would as well, so you can have the monster trucks to work on and all of the other various drag cars. There's a couple of lowered cars as well. If people are liking these videos, I may well go and prat around with some more of them and see what some of the different cars have to offer. I don't think there are any new engines in this. There are new engine swaps. Like I said, W12 goes in a fair few cars. Ah, crap, we forgot the ABS thing. That's fine. We will have the optional flywheel. I think, I managed to spam click through clutch plates by accident. I don't remember there being upgradable parts for the clutch before either. This is relatively new stuff that is going on here. Again, you know, I'm glad to see this game is continually getting updated. I haven't got a gearbox. Gearbox V8. I can get a gearbox V8. Yeah, I was not expecting to see necessarily more DLC for this particular game, but it's always much appreciated. There's always been decent DLC. I do think it might, by the time this video comes out, it might be a little too late, but there was a sale on Car Mechanic Simulator. I think it's like $2.99 for the game, and I think most of the DLC is had money off it. It's a really good value for money, that, because this is a lot of fun. It's a great game to play around with. It's a great time killer, I find, is that it's something that you will put on and can easily accidentally spend a couple of hours just messing around. It's a nice, relaxing, throw stuff on car. Unlike My Summer Car is a little bit more stressful. There's a lot of comparisons between those two, which is, you know, hardly surprising, because they're kind of about similar sort of things. And yeah, this is definitely the more relaxing of the two. It's something that, yeah, you just kind of sit and faff around with for quite a while without realizing quite how long that while was. I also love how archaic the suspension on this thing is. This is a monster truck that has got, it's not quite leaf springs at the back here, but it's not far off. It's kind of half and half. It's kind of got these bits, and we do have a proper shock absorber going on here. Oopsie. It's not the most up to date of cars, shall we say. It's kind of, yeah, it's an interesting little system that we've got going on at the back, but there we go. If it works, I don't know how this thing drives. To be fair, I haven't actually seen one that's looked in good condition, because this thing came through the auction house and, well, in typical one-star car condition, was a pile of rust. So hopefully by the time we're done... have I not got another spring? That's disappointing. I have miscounted somewhere. Right, over this side. Go. I'm sure I'm going to have forgotten something somewhere. In fact, now that I've said that, I've just remembered where the bushing is. I know where I've missed a rubber bushing already. I don't think there's actually too many in this car to worry about. We haven't got wheels at the moment. That is a lot of positive camber going on there. That's an awful lot of positive camber for the ghost bit of car. Okay. Also, I do apologise. I don't know if you're going to be able to hear this. Normally, microphone's not too bad for picking up background noise. However, it is absurdly windy in England at the moment. And where I live, I'm back onto some fields, which means it does tend to get very, very noisy around here. Like, if it's even slightly windy, we tend to get an awful, awful lot. So, awful lot of noise kind of whistles around the buildings and so on. So, if you can hear that, I do apologise. That is the fun of the... The English weather. I think it's Storm Doris or something that's going on at the moment, or heading this way. We don't really name our storms very well, I'm going to be honest. The Americans are still very much got us beat when it comes to naming of storms. Also, I say storm, this means a little bit of wind and a tiny bit of snow for Scotland, is how it works in England. For those of you Americans who actually have proper storms, I apologise. We are, yeah, quite useless. However, that's... yeah, that's why there might be some wind noise going on in the background. That's it for the rear suspension, really. The shiniest of exhaust systems going on here. We have got most... Aha! Knew I was going to forget about them buggers. And then we get the drive axle as well in there. That would be helpful. We'll go around the other side. I think that is most of the car done, actually. We've got the ABS module to put back in. I've got wheels to go and buy. Because I've got to have a look, see if there are options for different wheels and so on. Right, let's drop this down, and we will finish off the monster piccolo. It doesn't look pretty monstrous at the moment, I'll be honest. It does, to be fair, kind of looks like a relatively normal one without the wheels on it, without wheels and without bodywork, etc. Where was the ABS? The ABS is actually a little bit, there it is. ABS is a little bit of a bugger to find. It was only when I took like almost the entire engine out that I realised this had this little ABS module and sort of control unit sort of tucked away in the corner. And as far as kind of extending the life of this game, there's a lot of new configurations of cars to play around with, as I said, with lots of different engines and so on. So while you'll have worked on this V8 engine before, you probably won't quite have worked on it inside something like this. So, I don't know, there's about 12 or so different combinations. There's quite a lot of different combinations as well. So, yeah, for actual longevity, this is a really rather good DLC. Shall we have a look? If we go under O, starter motor. Bugger, I knew there was something. It was, the starter motor was the only thing that I haven't put in the car. And that's, I mean, that's not bad going for me, considering it was the first time playing this game in quite a while. There we go. Actually, wait, hold on. There should be a performance one. I thought I'd bought one. Is there a performance one? No, there isn't a performance one. Okay, fair enough. We'll stick that in there. Okay, and then we've just got wheels and bodywork to do. So, let's go have a look at the wheel shop. I don't quite know what wheels we want on a monster truck. We could get some Bentley wheels, get the T-Series wheels. I'm not sure that they would quite work for our monster truck. I tend not to really... Okay, DeLorean wheels. Oh, that's quite tempting. I don't really care that much when it comes to wheels. I have like a set wheels that I use on Forza. I think it's a Team Dynamics one, like a big multi-spoke one that I will tend to go for. I tend to prefer the multi-spoke wheel, like not these ones that got five, the ones with many, many different spokes. That tends to be the one that I gravitate towards too, although that's a little bit too crazy for me. I'm thinking this one. We'll see how it looks on the car when they go on. Yeah, it just tends to be my preference when it comes to wheels. A little bit wobbly on the old screw front there, but never mind. We're on, and we've got the monster truck tyres as well. I say monster truck, I should probably use that in the loosest of terms, because it's... kind of is. It's an interesting combination of vehicles. At least these ones are going in nice and straight. That's fine. There's nothing bad can happen. I'm pretty sure it doesn't let you drive the car if the wheels are going to fall off it. I kind of wish it would let you drive the cars if the wheels were going to fall off it, just to punish you for your stupidity. Be quite entertaining. Now it's, I think, at a drivable state. If we go, yeah, everything is... Oh, wow, it's worth $85,000. That's not bad. Admittedly, that is also... That's without the full body put on, and I did spend a lot of extra money on, like, fuel pumps and... Or, not fuel pumps. I mean, fuel pumps important on performance parts, like performance fuel pump and all the other performance bits. Probably a decent way of making money. I think about $25,000 to buy this car. So, if you are looking for money, you are looking for to earning money, then what is going on with the camber? Good God, that looks undrivable. I've got distracted. Yeah, these new vehicles might be a good way of earning some cash. Right, body shop. Do we have any crazy... Oh, no, it's that one. Do we have any crazy options for stuff? Doesn't look like it. Tuner shop, possibly. There might be new stuff. Aha! I don't know if this is any new stuff, but there are options for it. So we're going to go for... you know what? We will just buy all of it and see what we like. Because I have the money to pratt around with the car. It is quite nice at times having a sandbox mode. Right, assemble. Can we not assemble the front? Maybe we can't actually put things like bonnets on it? Hold on a second. There does not seem to be any specific stuff for the monster version. Okay, well, we want those, and we want the fenders. And we want those. And we're going to want that. Okay, well, we'll just kind of stick the car together, and I'm hoping it'll at some point let me put on the front. Maybe it doesn't. Maybe it just... Maybe we don't have any options for the front of the car. Or maybe I've... assemble mode, thank you. I mean, it did come missing a lot of bits, and I just assumed that was because it was just a cheap thing from the auction house, as they often do tend to, but maybe we aren't allowed more than that. Yeah, that is the body condition at 100. Wow, that's 131,000. That is a lot of money. Okay, so it doesn't have any bodywork on. That's disappointing. We were going to mess around with some custom parts, and the only custom bits we've got are Taylor. I mean, I say disappointing, we have got a monster truck-ish. It's kind of vague off-roady thing. Monster truck is being a bit too kind to... I'm not trusting those wheels in the slightest. Also, you thought I'd forgotten. I hadn't. don't worry. There we go. We will fill the car up with oil. And then, I guess we can go... Oh, we'll go tune it first. That's what we'll do. We'll go tune it. See how much power the thing is producing. Where is the dipstick? It's somewhere around. I've seen it. There it is. Yeah, we might give it a little bit more. There we go. Little bit more oil. And that should be fine. We are good. Everything is 100%. So we will go and jump into... oh, we've got to move the car. I forgot. We've got to put that into the dyno room. Then we shall go and say hello to the interesting thing. Let's just give it a test run. So is that 420 horsepower to begin with? Now we're up to 780 horsepower. Now that's a lot of horsepower in a little hatchback. Admittedly, it is all-wheel drive little hatchback, so I can never remember how to do this one. People tell me, and then I forget, and then I don't really... this is one of those things I just don't really care about too much when it comes to this game. Hey, that'll do! Can we get it better than that? No. So we put that down there. Nope. That one there up, and then that one there up, and then we're still at 4%. Nope. There we go. Oh! 5. That one, nope, that one there's not good. That one is not good. That one's definitely not good. 5% will do. Sure. It's, either way, you know, it's a bit more power. It's a bit more power. We should be up to 800 horsepower now, probably. I don't know if that's 5% on base horsepower or 5%. It's, yeah, 800 horsepower. 800. I'm trying to think of the equivalent car. This is kind of a Fiat Panda-ish. So, an all-wheel drive, slightly lifted Fiat Panda. That is a terrifying prospect. Look at it. Well, we're going to give this a drive. I'm really concerned about those. Look at that camber. It can't be good. We might fall over. I hope we fall over. That would be fantastically, fantastically silly way to go. Well, from this angle, everything kind of looks relatively uneventful for our Piccolo. What happens when we... do that? There's a little bit of juddering around. Break! Okay. Suspension is a little bit on the bouncy side. It does kind of wallow. I'll be honest, there is a lot of wallowing around in this. It doesn't really handle. I mean, we've got kind of a monster vehicle. And it seems to be fitted with mountain bike tyres. That was a slight... I think that's perhaps part of the reason why it looks so bizarre. With the... okay, so with kind of issues with control at the moment. I'm not sure 800 horsepower was a good idea. I'm not sure 800... Now I see the outcome of the 800 horsepower. I'm beginning to wonder if this was a sensible choice. Ooh, I've just had a thought. Now, driving through there with this, when we mess around with the V6, what's it called? Malak, because you can properly go exploring in all the little containers and all the houses in that car, because it's small enough to fit in them, whereas this can fit in apparently one. I mean, this should be able to do some pretty awesome... There we go. We can do some awesome burnouts or donuts. It doesn't have four-wheel steering, unfortunately. Just stupid looking thing. It does kind of feel like, it certainly from third person, look a little bit more like it's... It's kind of the Colin McRae Rally, the later Colin McRae Rally games with their slightly pivoty handling. That kind of how it feels like. It's a little bit peculiar. And watching it from third person does make things slightly worse because you can kind of see the car pivoting around. We've had a small spin and bounce off a wall. It's fine. It's kind of fine. We're gonna clonk into... Well, we've not rolled it. Oh, there we go. Yes, we have. What the hell have I done? I've broken everything. We've got out of the map. We're off. Goodbye. Goodbye, scenery. Oh, maybe no. We're going back again. We're on the roof. We're doing 100 kilometers an hour into the... this has gone quite badly wrong. This has gone quite badly wrong, and I am so very glad. No, we didn't lose a bit. We're off a tree. Are we going to come back down, or are we stuck on the scene? Okay, I'm going to stop. I'm not touching anything anymore. There are no inputs from me now. It's just going. It's going. It's going to fall into the abyss. It's off. Come back. Not even city. Just come. Oh, where we are. We're boomerang. We're a boomerang car. We found a new use for it. Can we? If this manages to find its way back onto the ground at some point, I'm amazed we've found our way back into the actual map. Come on, land. That's the ground. You kind of landed. Come on. You can do it. You can make a landing. Tree. No, it was so close to a landing. Come on. Stop. No, you're going the wrong way again. Bad car. I'm guessing we've found like a weird invisible hitbox around the roof and now it's all gone very, very, very bizarre. Well, there we go. If you want to completely and utterly break space and time, an 800 horsepower V8 monster Fiat Panda is the way to go as we now bounce and shimmy our way towards the 200 kilometer an hour mark. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, goodbye.